Welcome back to Mortician for More Living. Although I told you all I was gonna start to do a video of boondocking. That's it. Boondocking. I was gonna do a boondocking video down south, but instead the weather changed up north, so I headed back up here. Plus I have my surgery next week. So I just want to show you some of the things I'm trying to get done prior to the surgery. I'm just trying to get everything set up so when I get home from the hospital, I have a place for me to sit, a place for me to drink beer, and of course a place that I can have my hookers come and say hello to me, you know, make me feel better. Alright, so I did some yard work in the last 3 days, and I had a Mr. Richard Hertz come by again. He helped me move some things around, and I'm not sure if you remember last year with the snowstorm, how everything was like a little mess in the backyard. So Mr. Hertz came by and helped us with the yard. Starting to get the garden going, and what I'm going to show you is how I get my garden going. Normally we used to put them, the plants already that were grown, and then we would put them into the garden. But this year we're gonna do something different, just so I don't bend it over. Bend over.
Say face down, ass
and,
up. That's the way we like to.
It'd be easier for me to get to the garden to pull the vegetables, pull this. But let me show you how the yard looks first of all, and then show you where the garden is gonna be now, and describe a little bit of the garden. All right. So, as always, guys, I appreciate you tuning in to another episode. This will be the last one before my hiatus. And make sure you go down there and press that subscription. And give me the thumbs up. And also, don't forget to hit that notification bell so you won't miss another episode when I come back. If I do. All right, let's go. Alright, so this is the side of the yard here. It's actually the back door is right there.
Say face down, ass up!
So here's the back door. And that's where the kitchen is. And usually we come out to here. And Bob's over here. And here's the table he's sitting. It's a new table my wife bought. Probably Amazon. And if you see, it's a nice table. See it? My buddy Slick will have a great time on that table. You know why? Because it's perfect height for him. It's basically made for midgets.
We represent the
Lollipop Gang. Alright, so this is perfect for Slick. But I don't know if it's perfect for me. I'm a little bit of a fat guy, but let me show you the rest of the yard. Come on. All right, so here is the side of the house. There's a little flower bed. We used to have a pond in there, but we don't have a pond there no more. All the cats got the fish. All right, so here is where the little table is for the little guy, the lollipop gang. They'll sit here. And here is a palace we got. I stained them. And what we did is we're gonna put this shed here to relieve some relief from the other shed. But this is where the barbecue is. So it's really close to the patio where we can sit with the little guy. Poor Slicky. And then here's the door that comes out from the kitchen. Alright, well here is where I'm going to start to do my gardening. I'm going to put all, this year we're doing all buckets, and I'll explain that. And I'll put all the mixtures together. The little chair that my little buddy Ray got us. Mr. Sleepy. Mr. Sleepy Pants. Here is where we put the wood all winter long. Normally I buy two cords, but this year I'm gonna buy three. because it was cold last year. And our oil tank went down for a little while, so oil burner, I should say. So if I get more wood this year, it'd be all lined up here. So we built these two new racks. Well, Mr. Hertz did, not me. I just watched. And over here, I'll show you what we did over here. But over here is my father's car. somebody had a little fender bender. So this here is where our garbage cans are, right? And reason why we put these crates, I stained them. It took me about 4 days to stain that one. And about another 4 days to stain this one. So what I did, you can see there's an opening here, and the garbage cans will now go behind the fence, and the milk crates, whatever they call those big pallets. And the reason why we did that is because we live in a wind tunnel, which you'll see here, between two houses, and the wind throws these all over the yard, and shit goes everywhere. So now, with these milk crates, I'm going to put a latch or something here for here to keep them in, but a little dwarf, Sleepy, he came up with a good idea. Sleepy, oh, it was fell, going to put a bungee cord across it and keep it all in there, and it keeps it clean. My wife wanted the pallets, because she said it looks like it's in the country. All right, so that's for that. And now let me show you what I'm going to do with the garden materials, the buckets. Come on. Hey, everyone. I'm in the garden now, and I'm going to show you. A couple of years ago, we put garden beds in. We raised them a little bit. But because of next week, and when I come back, we've decided to raise them a little bit more, and we're going to do flower pots this year in the garden on one side with the tomatoes and peppers and things like that on one side, and we're going to do them in pots because we've noticed when they grow in pots, it's a little more cleaner and there's not as many weeds, and I'll show you how I covered up everything. And then the other side will be all our zucchini and eggplant and squash will be on the other side. So let me just show you a little bit of garden here. Oop, got my hand in front of the damn thing. All right, so this is the one side here where my wife started putting the, squash and zucchini. So this side will be all squash and zucchini. As I said, that won't be, it's a raised bed already, which I'll show you. But then, let me show you the other side, okay. Now the other side here is where I put, is this milk crate. And I put cinder blocks, and I'll show you. I end up putting the cinder blocks here to put the pots on, and it's easier for me to reach the tomatoes, and here the string will guide them going higher. Okay, so this is the whole side. It'll be tomatoes and peppers, and this is a good area. It's let me see, yeah, a good 6x9. On this side. This side is a little, oh, let me get on this side. This side is a little longer. Let me see, I could probably put about 10 deceased bodies in there, so it's about 7x13. All right, and let me just give you another view of the beds instead of me being my freaking fat head in the way. Okay, let me show you. See, so as I mentioned, I have them now on cinder blocks, which it Mr. Hertz will come by tomorrow and put one more here, and then one more here where I could fit. It's going to be two heirloom or three heirloom, Shaka style, three heirloom tomatoes. The wife likes the beefy ones. She likes the beefy ones, all right. All right, and then here, I'm going to have three here, about four here, and then one more here. And those are going to be my plump tomatoes, which I make my own tomato sauce for the pasta. As I mentioned, here is squash and zucchini started. I got a couple more that I'll put in this area. And they put the black stuff over it. I forget what it is. It's gardening material, some crap like that. And it avoids the weeds coming up. But as you can see, weeds still come up anyway. Here will be another spot that I'm gonna clean up a little bit more with Mr. Hertz. And look at this. Onions are coming up all by themselves. They have onions there, onions here, here. Look at all the onions here. All coming up by themselves, and they're great in the garden, or I mean in the sauce, or in a little salad. Okay, so this used to be my mulch pile, but since I've been gone, my wife really did a nice number on it and basically ruined it. And she left me this nice pile of shit. And I don't know why she left me the shit, but she did. Why? This is what I deal with. Here is a rock garden that she built. And all the parsley, oregano, thyme, cilantro, as she would say, is all in here. It's already growing. Now, I never planted none of this. This is for the last 4 years that we've had this rock wall here. And these are growing on their own, believe it or not. All right, believe it. All right, so this is going to be my my garden area. And I want to show you one more thing that we've done. So as I mentioned, I'll be sitting here filling the buckets up. I'm going to use garden sorrel, which is organic. And then we have some peat moss and some organic, looks like lime pellets, but they say it's a fertilizer. Will it give us cancer? I guess in the next 10 years we'll find out. And then here is my chair that Sleepy bought for the old lady last year. He's such a nice little Sleepy Pants. Just kidding, brother, but it's funny though. I like that nickname. All right, so I'm gonna make about 8 pots with 3/4 sorrel, 1/4 of the, no, half sorrel, 1/4 fertilizer, and 1/4 peat moss. I'll mix it together. Will it work? Who knows? Hey everyone. Thanks again for watching Mortician to More Living. I would like to end this episode today with the meaning of Memorial Day. Memorial Day is coming up this weekend, and we would like to say that the meaning of Memorial Day is for the soldiers who have lost their lives defending our freedom. Although it's always great to be with friends and family, have a barbecue, have hamburgers and hot dogs, and some beers. Well, I can't have no beers right now. But it's always great to thank a soldier. We appreciate their services to this country. But we really want to honor the soldiers, the men and women who have lost their lives defending our freedoms. Our freedoms to march. Our freedoms of speech. Our freedoms of religion. Our freedom. Our freedom. Our freedom. We thank them. We honor them. We honor their families who have lost their loved ones. But we, most of all, we thank God for making us Americans. Thank you to all those soldiers who have sacrificed their lives. I will always be grateful. Thank you. God bless. I'll see you all soon. Love you. Ciao, ciao.